Jesus.
Let's put our hands together and welcome Apostle.
We give you praise.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say, my Father, I receive instant answers to my prayers. I receive, instant manifestation to my prayers in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. Say, Lord Jesus. Say it again. Say, Lord Jesus. Save my soul. Transform my life. Open my eyes. Give me understanding. Stir my faith. Let your wonders take place in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Were you able to repeat what I said? Did you hear what I said? Were you able to repeat it? Are you sure? Amen. The things I ask you to declare are very deliberate. Because if your soul is not saved, you will go to hell. And you can go to church all your life and not be saved. You can go to church all your life. Where church has become a place where you go to meet friends. Where you are going to church to please somebody or to impress somebody. Where you are going to church to fulfill the command of somebody. Not because there is a link between you and God. That is what I've been telling you to repeat. Save my soul. I know of an evangelist who died and was going to hell. So this heaven and hell matter, we don't joke with it. You have to be constantly conscious of it. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The Bible says that work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. This evangelist that I'm talking about, when he died, Jesus said, you are going to hell. He said, I've been preaching righteousness. Jesus said, yes, you have been preaching righteousness, but you didn't forgive your wife.
So
your wife offended you, didn't forgive her. So you are going to hell. So we shouldn't joke with these things. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Every morning when you wake up, God, forgive me my sins. Every time when you wake up, confess. Because one unconfessed sin can take you to hell. A sin that you have forgotten about can take you to hell. Before you go to bed, ask God, Lord, please forgive me my sins.
Lord,
I'm sorry for any bad thing I might have done in the day. All the years that you have been going to church must not be wasted years. Your place in heaven must be secure. Say it again. Say, Lord Jesus, save my soul. Transform my life. Open my eyes. Stir my faith. Give me understanding. Let your wonders take place in my life. In the name of Jesus Christ. As you are praying those prayers, if there is any hidden something in your life that will take you to hell, God will bring your attention to it. Am I communicating to somebody? God has a way of bringing your attention to it by the Holy Spirit, through the preaching, through something that a friend will say, so that you don't lose your soul. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Somebody say the anointing. Say the anointing. We have been talking about the anointing. And we have learned how to get the anointing. You must know how to get something. If you don't know how to get the thing, you don't know the thing. Am I communicating? If you are a footballer,
so you'll be a,
or you are a striker,
and I say,
and you don't know how to score goals, then it means you don't know your job. So when we are talking about anointing, and you don't know how to get the anointing,
it means
that all the lessons has not benefited you. Before we can say that the lesson has benefited you, before we can say that the lecture or the teaching has benefited you, then it means that you know how to get the thing. You know how to lay hold on the thing. So I always talk about how to get the anointing. I don't only talk about anointing. When we are talking about prosperity, you must not only hear about prosperity, but you must know how to get the prosperity. When we are talking about promotion, you must not only hear about promotion, but you must know what to do to get the promotion. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So many church goers have anointing at their doorstep. They have anointing close to them, but they are dry of anointing because they don't know how to relate with the anointing. They don't know how to capture the anointing. They don't know how to connect to the anointing.
They
don't know how to receive the anointing. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we have learned that
yes, you are saying
the word of God brings the anointing. We have learned that prayer brings the anointing. We have learned that worshiping God brings the anointing. We have also learned that righteousness brings the anointing. We have learned all these things from the word of God. So when you are prayerless, and you hate prayer, forget about anointing. So we are showing the things that you have to do to be anointed. If you don't like the word of God, you have no respect for the word of God, forget about anointing. You can never get it. Am I communicating to somebody? If you disrespect righteousness, righteousness is nothing to you. Forget about anointing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
If you are not somebody who is grateful to God,
it is
gratefulness that leads you to worship God.
Because
it is the overflow of your gratefulness and appreciation to God that makes you praise God. That makes you worship God. That makes you celebrate God. And that will draw God into your life for the anointing to come upon your life. So we have learned that when the Spirit of God comes into a person's life to fulfill his God-given assignment, we say he is anointed. When the Spirit of God comes upon a person's life to fulfill the assignment God has given to him, then we say that the person is anointed. There are different kinds of assignments. We have pastoral assignment. Somebody has been called with an assignment as a pastor. Are you with me? The word of God is more important than the phone, so look at me. Amen. I said somebody has been called to be a pastor.
Your friend say
to promote the agenda of God through pastoring. Somebody has been called to use politics to promote the things of God. You see, when God gives you something, it is not for yourself, it is for his kingdom. He said to Abraham, I will bless you so that you will become a blessing. And so God has called somebody to be a doctor, so he will use the doctoral influence to promote the agenda of God.
And
God can also bless you to become a great manager, a great administrator, to be in high position, great accountant, you have influence in the place. The agenda is not to make you swollen headed and to maltreat people. The agenda is to promote the will of God. If you are a teacher, you are not only teaching the children mathematics, because the mathematics and the science is earthly. It will not cross the grave. It has no eternal value. It only has earthly value. So as a teacher, your assignment as a teacher, you must use it to connect the children not only to mathematics but also to God.
Also to God.
That is what has eternal value.
So
every assignment you have, every position you have, every influence you have, every role you have, every power you have, it is God who has given it to you so that you will use it to promote the agenda of God. Oh Lord, this position you have given to me, show me how to use it to promote your agenda. Show me, give me wisdom on how to use it to promote your agenda. Some people, God has given them money, and they use the money to fight the things of God. They don't know the purpose of the money. Amen. They use the money to fight the things of God. There was a man called KSM some years ago who went to buy airtime to preach against tithing. It's called KSM. Yes. Today he doesn't have a voice again. Today you don't even hear of him. Even what the thing is doing on TV, nobody is
Speaking.
Because nobody can fight God. If you fight God, you will disappear. For years he was on radio. For years he was on radio. Praise God. Today nobody is hearing of him again. We don't fight the things of God. There was a man who was called
Saul,
who later became Paul. He wanted to fight the things of God. Then he started attacking the apostles. He said these people are deceiving people. So he started arresting the apostles and the Christians. You can't fight God. Then Jesus released one light, and he became blind. There are some areas we don't go there. Areas that have to do with God, we don't go there. Praise God. When God gives you political power, you don't use it to draw the things of God back. You don't say things to make people angry with God. God has given you political power. You are a minister. You are an MP. And you want to use that power to turn people against God. In the name of objectivity. Very soon, God will still be there, and you will be nowhere to be found. Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Before democracy came and then we started doing these things, churches were there and they were saving souls for Christ. Before they started voting for people to become MPs and everything, churches were there. They were saving souls for Christ. Praise God. Yes. There was one time, there was a certain head of state in Ghana. If you say anything bad about him, you disappear. Your family will not see you again. But today, where is he? Was very powerful. If you say anything
against
him, they will come for you. Today, where is he? Where is he? God is the Almighty. God is the all powerful. I said, God is the Oga Kwata 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 Kwata. Whatever he gives to us, let's find a way of using it to promote his
identity.
Give the Lord a mighty clap of
praise.
And there are things that represent God. They stand for God. There are things that represent God. When you are dealing with those things, be careful. There are things that represent God. When you are dealing with those things, be careful. The first thing that represents God are messengers of God.
Messengers of God.
Who carry the message of God to people.
It
represents God.
There's
another thing that represents God is the church of God. When you are dealing with those things, be very careful. Praise God. The anointing. Now, when the anointing comes upon you, then God can use you. Anytime we say that God is using this person, God is using this person, it is because the anointing is upon the person.
So
without the anointing, God cannot use you. So anybody that we can point our finger, the Lord is using her. The Lord is using
him.
It means that the anointing is upon the person.
So
it is the anointing that makes you usable by God. It is the anointing that makes you usable by God. Without the anointing, you will not be useful to God. Without the anointing, you will not be a worthy instrument for God to use. May the anointing of the Lord come upon your life in the name of Jesus Christ. The anointing that will qualify you, the anointing that will make you acceptable in the sight of God, the anointing that will make you useful to God, may that anointing come upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. So without the anointing, we are useless in the sight of God. The world needs certificate and qualification for you to become useful to the world.
In the world.
Certificate and qualification. And connections. To become useful to the world. But God, what you need to become useful to God is his anointing upon your life, his approval upon your life, his spirit upon your life. That's what makes you usable. That's what makes you an instrument for God. That's what makes you a channel for God. Praise the Lord. Say, I am receiving the anointing. Say it again. Say, I am receiving the anointing. So, I don't want you to become ignorant of the anointing. I don't want you to become ignorant of how to get the anointing. Last week, we learned that the anointing gives you vision. You cannot be anointed and be visionless. The anointing comes upon your life. It brings direction into your life. It brings vision into your life. It brings purpose into your life.
So
you cannot carry the anointing and be aimless in life. You cannot carry the anointing and be somebody who is going nowhere in life. The anointing makes you a visionary.
Makes you a
visionary. That's what the anointing does in your life. Nobody can look at your life and your life looks wayward if the anointing comes upon your life. Nobody can look at you and your life looks like you are nothing. Once the anointing comes upon your life, it brings vision. It brings clarity. It brings wisdom. It brings direction. Say, I am receiving that anointing. So if I can say, I am receiving that anointing. Anybody who has the anointing is a purposeful person. It's a purposeful person. You cannot deviate him. You cannot derail him. Because we have learned from the Bible that the anointing teaches you. So nobody can dissuade you and disconnect you from God. Nobody can cut you off from God. Nobody can prevent you from becoming committed to God. Because the anointing is upon your life and it is teaching you, it is speaking to you, it is talking to you. I pray for you in the name of Jesus that this anointing that I'm talking about shall rest upon your life. This anointing that I'm talking about shall work in your life. This anointing that I'm talking about shall manifest in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. But you can be around anointing and be destitute of anointing. Yes, you can be around anointing and be destitute of anointing. One of the major channels God used to transfer anointing are his servants.
Major,
one of the major.
Amen.
Major. Through Moses, God imparted anointing to Joshua.
Now Moses, so Joshua, onyangosra.
Through Elijah, God imparted anointing to Elisha.
And Elijah, so Elisha, onyangosra.
Through Samuel, God imparted anointing to David.
And I'm Samuel, so David nyangusra.
Through Moses, God imparted anointing to Aaron.
And I'm Moses, so Aaron isra nengo.
God chooses vessels and channels to use to transfer anointing to
us.
You need connection and contact with those vessels. A link. You need a link with those vessels. You are here. Praise God. Yes. Bishop Charles Ejinasari, God used Dr. Maurice Cerillo to transfer anointing.
Bishop Doug Mills,
God used Kenneth Hagin to transfer anointing to him.
Yes.
God didn't give it to them direct.
Mm-hmm.
They were praying, they were fasting. But God chose a vessel. Even it to people direct is not very common.
It's not very common.
If you study the Bible, there are few cases where God gave it to the people direct. Most of the times, it is through a human channel. Praise the Lord. Yes. Even Moses, who God met him direct at the mountain, there was a man in his life who was tutoring him.
The man
is called the priest of Midian.
The priest, not the Midian,
who gave his daughter to Moses to marry. He was a mentor to Moses. And he was teaching Moses the ways of God. That's how come Moses was qualified to receive the anointing direct from God. Praise the Lord. Archbishop Duncan Williams received it from Idahosa. Reverend Eastwood Anaba received it from Archbishop Duncan Williams.
Duncan Williams.
Reverend Dr. Ampia Kofi received it from Archbishop Duncan Williams. My bishop said, the day he received the miracle anointing, he went for a pastor's conference. And they were showing Maurice Cerullo on a video. And he said, when Maurice Cerullo cries, he also cries. When Maurice Cerullo cries, he also cries. Whatever Maurice Cerullo was doing in the video, he was also doing
some.
Then there was a transfer. Anybody whose words you don't respect, his anointing can never come to you. Anybody that you don't reverence, its anointing can never come to you. Anybody you never want to imitate anything about him, his anointing can never come to you. One of the things I like about my bishop is that he comes to church early. He comes to church early. When I was a prayer warrior, I was understanding him. He comes to church before church starts. Even if there are zero people in the church, you make sure that the intercession must start. If there's nobody in the church, intercession must start. I learned it from him. He also closes on time. So if I cannot learn anything from him, it means I've disregarded him. It means I don't reverence him. His anointing can never flow into my life. Because it is the anointing you respect that you receive. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I was asked to speak to the Perez pastors at pastors conference. And when the presiding bishop was introducing me, he said, during the January fasting, I sent Bishop Raymond to visit some of the churches. To go and see how they are doing the January fasting. When he got to some of the churches, 5 people, 6 people, 10 people, 15 people, 20 people, in the evening service, the January fasting. But when you go to a man from where, by the grace of God, I was pastoring, the presiding bishop said they saw about 200 people gathered in the evening praying.
In the evening
fasting and prayer. So the presiding bishop invited me to talk to the pastors at the pastors conference.
Come and
give us practical tips.
On
what you have been doing at the evening service, 200 people gathered. And I told the pastors.
Me ka ti aso funo.
I learned from the Bishop Charles Ejin Asare.
Me suen fi aso funo.
All that I did in Amanfro.
Ni ame ye wa Amanfro mu nyina no.
Were things I learned from the Bishop
Charles. Eye ni aso funo ye no, en na me koye o.
I didn't do anything different.
Ya ye biribia surunku bia.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So the grace of the Bishop Charles Ejin Asare to grow the church will work.
And it's Adom na wo yo so popon so no and na me ye wo na so no say say enyini.
I think you were in that conference. You were there. Pastor Gideon was there.
Me and me so.
One of the things I told the pastor is that my bishop doesn't joke with his work.
Yeah. I said I'm so osokopon on fana sem in
the
agro.
The Bishop Charles Ejin Asare, he doesn't joke with his work.
On fana sem in the agro.
He's very serious with his work.
Oh, the nejuma on fana ejuma in the agro.
Amen.
Amen.
When you're also serious with your work will
go on. So what
as a secretary, as a teacher, as an accountant, as a businesswoman. When you're serious with your work,
so uma wajuma no uma wenu kwa huwa.
It will produce.
Ebeni.
Praise God. So one of the ways you can get the anointing. Let me show you. Through serving. An anointed person.
Sir, we bear sum obi a wongo serano.
Serving an anointed person.
We bear sum obi a wongo serano. Wongo serano ya sum.
Serving an anointed person.
Sir, we bear sum obi a wongo serano.
I have to serve my Bishop Charles Ejin Asare.
Sir, me sum me sokupon.
He said, go to Amanfro. I go.
Go to Amanfro na Odiso.
He said, go to Tema. I go.
Sir, bra Tema me diso.
He said, I want you to handle the breakthrough service, the Tuesday service at
Jowlu.
I said, yes, sir. No complaint. No murmuring. No grumbling.
Serve.
He said, I am going here. Let's go. I follow him. I don't elevate my will about his, above his, and give him excuses. That is how we get the transfer. Must get to the level where the anointed can tell you, come to church, and you still come. That's that means his word carry weight in your life. That is how the anointing
except
on
him. Sorry. Na wa ba sorry. Na che se na sem emu yedru o abra bom sing asem bia.
But there are some people who are filled with their own mind.
Ah, you ni pebu wa oni ne woni ti ne woni ti mo.
So they are around an anointing. But the anointing cannot work in their lives. May the Perez anointing work in your life. I said, may the Perez anointing work in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So serving the anointed.
Say, we be sum.
In fact, 1 Kings chapter 19, from verse
19.
Are you working with me? 1 Kings chapter 19, from verse
19.
So he said, Elijah departed from there.
And Elisha free her.
And he found Elisha.
Now who Elisha?
The son of Shaphat.
Dina no wabono.
Who was plowing with 12 yoke of oxen before him?
Oh yeah, Juma, I want to fool mu.
And Elijah put his mantle upon him.
Nah, Elijah the nengo strano eto no so.
Elijah put his mantle upon him.
The nengo strano eto no so.
Another name for the anointing is mantle.
Say kase nengo strana.
Yes. Another name for the anointing is mantle.
Eh, no puma.
Elijah put
puma.
The mantle upon him.
Also, the no puma no to no so.
And then he did something.
Nah, oh yeah,
the next verse. When he put the mantle upon him, Elisha left.
Elisha free her.
What he was doing.
No,
and he started following Elijah.
Odi Elisha echi.
Started following Elijah.
So Elisha echi.
Before an anointing can come upon you, you must follow the anointing.
Ah, so person go sraba osu ya. So odi go sran echi.
The anointing you follow. The anointing you follow. It is the anointing that can come upon your life. The anointing you pursue after. Is the anointing that can work upon your life. You follow him through his social media handles. You follow that anointing. You listen to him. On my phone, I have my bishop's messages are downloaded. I have the messages of Bishop Dag and big men of God. In addition to my bishop, I follow them. Anytime my bishop is doing program somewhere, I will receive a message that bishop is preaching life. Then quickly I get connected.
So
you follow them by reading their books. You follow them by listening to their tapes. You follow them by watching their videos. So Elisha left and followed him. He left and followed him. What have you left to follow an anointed? What have you left? Some of us cannot leave a television program to go and listen to the anointed. So we are members of the church. But the anointing over the church is not working in our lives. Am I talking to somebody here? Today I'm teaching. I'm not preaching. The teaching talks direct. The preaching makes people happy. The teaching talks direct. It enters the people and matures them. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Elijah said to Elisha, go back, go back.
Elijah catch Elijah,
go back. I've not done anything to you. I just put the anointing upon you and you are following me.
Now the match.
Yes. He said, go back. The anointing that has affected you.
About so no,
or the anointing that you have allowed to affect you. You always look for that anointing. You always chase after the anointing. You always pursue the anointing. But the anointing you ignore, the anointing you disregard, the anointing you overlook can never enter your life. It can never work upon your life. There are times I sit down and I just meditate about Bishop Chacheji Nasare. I sit down and meditate on him. I meditate on how he does his things. I sit down and meditate on him. It is a way of receiving the spirit that is upon him. Sit down and meditate upon him. I think about him. How he does his things. How he goes about his things. How he organizes his things. How he arranges his things. How he does his ministration. I just sit down and meditate about him. Say, I'm receiving the anointing. Yes. Then go to the next verse. Then he returned and went to kill all the animals he was using to farm. He went to close down the business. And went to minister to Elijah. He went to serve him. There are different ways of serving the anointing. Everybody must find his own way of serving the anointing. The way that this man can serve the anointing is different from the way that this man can serve the anointing.
Amen.
So Elisha sacrificed something. Elisha lost something. Elisha gave away something to be able to follow Elijah. So you cannot follow an anointing, you are not ready to sacrifice anything for. It's very important. Now I'm going to show you the process. Of getting the anointing, the process. A testimony was given about Elisha. 2 Kings chapter 3 verse 11. 2 Kings chapter 3 verse 11.
Ahimfuma to sumie nu ti mi enzan ti chemuduba.
Somebody gave a testimony about Elisha.
Obidin ho adanse.
He said Elisha the prophet is here. He is the one who poured water on the hands of Elijah.
O say na Elisha odifu no owa ha. Ono no ohie insugu, anaso ohie insugu. Elijah insatu.
To pour water on the hands of Elijah means he served him.
Say ka so bi hie insugu ni insatu a ase chere se osume no. Abebu abebusem.
Yes, he served him.
Osume no.
So somebody was talking about Elijah.
You know, Obi Kasafa Elijah.
This is the attribute of Elijah. He poured water on the hands of Elijah.
Nisu enane bain no oshie nsugu Elijah.
The day that Elijah got anointed,
that Elijah nyango srano,
Elijah the prophet discouraged him.
Elijah odifuno
obunabem, he discouraged him.
Obunabem pi.
2 Kings chapter 2.
From
verse 1. 2 Kings chapter 2 from verse 1. The day Elisha got anointed, Elijah the prophet discouraged him. You must get to the level where you refuse to be discouraged.
You
must get to the level. Because the anointed man will offend you. Yes, he will offend you. And that offense can discourage you. And you will lose the anointing. So on that day, it came to pass. And the Lord wants to take Elijah to heaven. To take him away from Elisha. Continue to the next verse. And Elijah said unto Elisha,
now Elijah catch Elisha say,
stay here, stay here. I am going somewhere and come.
Baby.
He was taking the anointing away.
No, then go strane ko.
He was taking the anointing away.
No, then go strane ko.
And Elisha said to him,
Elijah catch and say,
as the Lord liveth,
and
as thy soul liveth, I am not sitting here. Wherever you are going,
baby, I beko no.
I am going with you. You follow the anointing in order to get the anointing. You get connected to the anointed. Any way that you can connect to the anointed, make sure you get connected. Let me tell you this secret. Anytime you meet an anointed vessel,
and
you like the anointing on that vessel, connect with that anointing. Anytime you see an anointing, an anointed vessel, and you like the anointing on him, connect. Connect. One of the things that you know that this anointing is for me is that when he speaks, something resurrects inside you. When he speaks, something resurrects inside you. It means that anointing is for you. It means that anointing is entering you. It means you are receiving transfer of the anointing. When he speaks, something resurrects inside you. When he speaks, some life enter you. When he speaks, it looks like your problems have been swallowed up. When he speaks, you receive hope. When he speaks, your discouragement disappears. When he speaks, you receive answers to your questions. That anointing has been sent to you. It belongs to you. It belongs to you. Connect permanently. And your life will change. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Continue to verse 3.
Also.
And the sons of the prophet came to Elisha and they said, today God is going to take your father Elijah away.
Yes.
Yes.
He
said, I know.
He
said, I know. Keep quiet. I know it.
Na minim dada.
Keep quiet.
Minim
you see,
dada.
There were many sons of the prophet who were following Elijah, but none of them got anointed. None of them got it. It was only one.
Yes.
Yes. Elisha. It was only Elisha who got
Elisha
the thing.
Pe.
So a pastor like Bishop Ejinasari can have many pastors under him.
Yes.
Yes. He can have many pastors under him. He can have many reverend ministers under him. He can have many apostles under him. It's not all of them who are interested in the anointing. Some of them are only interested in money. Some of them too, they are only interested in position. There are only few who are interested in the real anointing. And those who are interested in the anointing, when they don't get money, they still follow. When they don't get promotion, they still follow. But those who are there for different agenda, position, title, money, and things, they will say, me, a juman, me, nyebiyom. Nyebiyom. Your purpose is wrong. Your agenda is wrong. You will lose everything. Praise the Lord. Am I communicating to somebody? Yes. He said, he's coming. He said, I know. Don't tell me. I know.
Man can't tell me name.
I know. Am I talking to somebody? Go to the next verse. And then Elijah said unto him, wait here, I am going to Kumasi and come. So the anointing you respect, everywhere the anointing is going, if only you can go, you will go with him. Yes. One day, Bishop was going to hold a program at Volta region.
Then he said, David, come and let's go.
So when you the program, before he will preach, he will make me to preach 30 minutes or 15 minutes before he will come. And then he will tell me, this is the topic I want you to preach on. Then he said, this is the book I want you to use.
Yes.
I must obey. And I must listen. So if you see somebody rising with somebody, it's because he's following some instructions.
Yes.
So, I was not supposed to preach what I wanted. I need to listen.
He said,
this is the book you are using. This is the topic you are preaching on. So any time before he will preach, I will preach for 30 minutes. Then you will take over.
So he
left Volta region. Then he went to Tamale.
No, call Tamale.
I was waiting for him to call me again before I go.
I said, I'm a call.
So he didn't call me.
One frame.
And he went to Tamale.
No, call Tamale.
Then the Holy Ghost said to me, you are stupid. You are waiting for your bishop to invite you.
So no frame, sir.
You go and escort him.
And son, Tamale.
The first invitation was to teach you a lesson. And when he's going somewhere, learn to follow. Don't wait for him to tell you first.
So can chill.
Am I communicating to somebody? Recently, he was going to Zoe to go and do a
program.
Then he said, oh, I want you to go with me to Zoe. Then I followed him. Now I have lenses. When he's going somewhere, I will not wait for him to say
that.
I follow. To serve. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. That is how the anointing is transferred. So continue to the next verse. Yes, so even here too, Elijah said, wait here, I am going somewhere. And Elisha said, no, I will follow you. Go to verse 5. Fast. And the sons of the prophets that were at Jericho came to Elisha and said unto him, do you know that God will take your master away? He said, yes, I know. Keep quiet. Go to the next verse. And Elijah said unto him, wait here, I want to go and come. He said, no, I will go with you. And they went together. Go to the next verse. And then the 50 spiritual sons of the prophet, they went to stand far away.
Now
they were watching Elijah and Elisha. Those who have different agenda, they are looking for promotion, they are looking for position, they are looking for money. Every time they are far away. They are far away. But those who are interested in the anointing, they are close. So your desire will either bring you close to the anointed or it will drive you away.
So
there were also spiritual sons, but they were far away and they were watching. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Yeah. But Elisha was close.
Elijah no beno.
So verse 8. And Elijah took the mantle. And smote the Jordan River. And the Jordan River divided. So it is the mantle that will open ways. The anointing you follow is what will open ways for you.
Yes.
That is what will open ways for you. The anointing you desert cannot open ways for you. And so verse 9, the Lord took away Elijah. And when he took away the Elijah, the mantle fell. And Elisha took the mantle. And he also used it to divide the river. Go to the next verse, verse 10. He also used that same mantle to divide the river. Whatever the anointing does for your master, that now the anointing will do the same thing for you. If it gives breakthrough to your master, it will give breakthrough to you. If it gives favor to your master, it will give favor to you. Go to verse 11. Verse 11. Yes. And they still went on. And they were talking together. Yes. And then that was how he was taken. Go to verse 12. And Elijah saw that his spiritual father was taken away. Go to verse 13. And he took the mantle
also of far
and divided
the bones.
Took the mantle and divided
the Jordan.
The anointing I operate with is the Ejinasari anointing.
Amen.
Amen. It will only work for me if I respect it. If I respect it, it will work for me. If I respect it, the result is getting in the dome. I'll also start.
There is a requirement.
I must reverence the anointing upon him. I must cherish the anointing upon him. I must value the anointing upon him. Go to the next verse. Let's see what happened. Let's see what happened. And when the sons of the prophet, which were viewing the thing, they were spectators, they were not involved. They said, the spirit of Elijah is resting on Elisha. And they came to him and they bowed. They came to him and they bowed. A time is going to come. You were in the same clash with somebody. But the anointing will make the difference. A time will come. You were in the same department with somebody. The anointing will make the difference. I was together with him at the children department. We are all together in the media. We are all together in the music department. But the anointing will make the difference. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
It is the anointing that will make others to bow to you. It is the anointing that will make others to salute you. It is the anointing. Make sure you get the anointing. It will speak for you. It will work for you. It will advance you. It will accelerate you. It will open.
And
his preaching does not revive me. I change the station. I look for another station. I want a preaching that will revive me. There are too many things that are discouraging us from following God. There are too many things discouraging us from praying, discouraging us from fasting, discouraging us from being spiritual. I am looking for a preacher that can revive me. I'm looking for a preacher that
can spare me. I'm looking for a preacher that will bring life into me. I'm looking for a preacher that after listening to him, I want to go and study the Bible. I want to go and pray. I want to go and fast. I want to serve God more. That is how the anointing is imparted. Elisha got the anointing.
Elisha, you will
get the anointing.
I said,
you will get the anointing. You
will
heal the sick.
You
will cast out devils. You will work wonders. You will work miracles. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. One day,
that
I was
me.
Talking to one of our pastors.
Who
told me? As for him, dear. When Bishop Ejinasari preaches, he doesn't feel anything. He doesn't feel anything. And I said to him, that is why you are struggling. That is why you are struggling. That's why your church is not flourishing. For this word to come from your mouth. That when Bishop Ejinasari preaches, you don't feel anything. Yet you are a pastor under him. He has ordained you. He has given you a branch. You are saying this. That is why you are struggling. One day he called me.
He
said, as you are going to Tema, every program that you will do, I want you to tell me so that I will also do some. But I didn't mind him. Because it will be a waste of time. If the Papa himself, his preaching does not move you, how much more me? It's a waste of time. I didn't mind him. The anointing, we can transfer it, and you can receive it. Are you sure you are hungry for the anointing? Are you sure? Are you sure you want the anointing to work in your life? Then rise to your feet. Jesus. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Say, I declare.
I said, make sure.
Say, I declare. I will not look down on the anointing. Say, I declare. I will not overlook the anointing. Say, I declare. I will not insult the anointing. In the name of Jesus Christ. Say, Holy Ghost, grant me grace to follow the anointing. Say, Holy Ghost, grant me grace to stick to the anointing. Say, Holy Ghost, grant me grace to be interested in the anointing. In the name of Jesus. Say, right now, I receive the power to follow the anointing, to like the anointing, to copy the anointing. In the name of Jesus.